व्यग्रह, व्यग्र मीन्स टू गेट डिस्टर्ब्ड, टू गेट एजिटेटेड, टू बी रेस्टलेस, टू बी टेंस्ड. एंड इन द वर्ल्ड वी फाइंड दैट व्हेन समथिंग इविल हैपेंस और समथिंग बैड हैपेंस और समवन डजंट डू व्हाट दे आर सपोज टू डू और दे हार्म अस और दे इंसल्ट अस, वी गेट वेरी डिस्टर्ब्ड. द लॉर्ड इज द वन हु रिमेन्स undisturbed, unaffected in any situation. Even when he has to punish anyone, like when he had to punish Daksha or Andhakasura, then also it is not out of hate. When we punish somebody, it may be out of hate. It may be that we are hurt so much. Bhagwan doesn't take it personally. Anyway, he is free from the ego. But still, to do the duty and out of compassion for the beings, he may even punish them. Like a mother may scold a child, but it is out of love. The mother, if she takes it personally and feels hurt, then that scolding will be of a different nature. But if she is not taking it personally, but only to correct the child, then that will express in a different way. In the same way, the Lord gives the results of karmas to all the jivas, and some of those results may be unpleasant, some of them may be even punishment, some of them may be to deprive them of certain things, some of them may be that they have to go through certain sorrow and suffering. But all that is done without any agitation inside. In fact, it is only compassion and love inside. Hence, he is called Avyagraha. And second meaning also is even the entire act of destroying the world. Bhagwan is a lord of destruction. So even when he has to destroy the entire creation, he is still unmoved, untouched, unaffected. This capability to be unaffected even in the most difficult circumstances is what we have to cultivate. As seekers and as devotees of Lord Shiva, this is one quality that we must have, that externally situations may be most turbulent, but we remain unaffected. Then only we are able to act most objectively and do the best in that given situation. Even when the Lord was insulted by Daksha in front of everybody, and many devatas and rishis also joined Daksha, Bhagwan did not feel insulted. Bhagwan did not even have a sense of revenge towards them. It is only when Sati immolated herself that Bhagwan was angry, and he created Virabhadra and Bhadrakali, who went and destroyed the yajna of Daksha. And finally, it is the Lord who restored the life of Daksha, gave him the head of a goat, etc. So it was only to correct Daksha. Bhagwan did not feel anything personal. He did not react and get upset and angry. That capability we must cultivate. Pujya Gurudev Swami Chinmayananda used to say that a successful person is one who builds a firm foundation with the bricks that others throw at him. So how to remain unaffected? How to remain equanimous? Even in the most difficult circumstances, most provocative circumstances, first and foremost, we must be very clear about our motives, our intentions, and about who we are truly. The world may say anything, the world may provoke us, but if we are sure we have not done anything wrong, we are sure of our motives are clean and pure, there is nothing to fear, there is nothing to be disturbed about. Second, what the world gives us is their choice, but how we respond is our choice. So we should always remember that choice is with us. Our state of mind cannot be controlled by others. We must choose what should be our response. That requires clarity of thought, and that also requires a certain amount of mind control. Third, as long as we depend on people's approval or validation or praise or appreciation to feel good or to feel worthy, it will not be possible for us to remain undisturbed. And our sense of self-worth comes from who we are, not from what people perceive us to be. That self-love and that inner strength help us to remain unaffected. Fourth is, we should always ask ourselves, am I taking it too personally? Even a valid criticism can be taken objectively so that we can improve. When we take things personally, we don't improve. We feel hurt, we react more. In fact, we fall lower. And sometimes we even prove the opposite person right by our reactions. So we should always ask, am I taking it personally? How is it that I can take it objectively? And what are the things that I should learn? If the statement made by the others is valid, is true, we can learn out of it and evolve. If it is false, we should learn to let go. Just ignore it. We cannot control people's thoughts. They can think anything, that is their choice. So not to take things personally is the fourth method. And the fifth is, we should drop the desire that people should look at us only in a certain way. Many times we want to control the perception of people about us. What they think about us should be what we want them to think about us. That desire we should drop. We do our duties, we are sincere, we even communicate, we explain, we express, so that everybody is clear about our actions, our intentions, our plans, etc. And if there is any clarification to be given, if there is any misunderstanding, those can be resolved by communication. But people having a certain image about ourselves is their choice. After I have done all this, I don't have to bother what they think about me. Because what truly matters is what I think about myself, and even more than that, what the Lord thinks about me. And have I done my duties? Have I been sincere? Have I been steadfast in performance of my duties? That is all that matters. Many times when we try to control the image that people have about us, we forget who we are. That is the greatest loss. So these are five ways. We can apply any of these or all of these and remain undisturbed. The cause is more important than I. Evolution, selflessness, egolessness, compassion, love, these are more important than any other image factor or any approval or any validation or any appreciation. So if we have the priorities right, we will be able to remain unaffected, untouched, unmoved. May the Lord bless us with this capability to remain equanimous in the most provocative situations. One more way is to identify what are my attachments, because only when our attachment is affected, we will react. If I'm attached to some object or some person or a certain habit and that is threatened, then we will react. So finding out what are my attachments and help and taking steps to overcome them is the method to make our mind strong, and that would help us to remain unaffected.
Om Namah Shivaya. namah Shivaya.